Hello and welcome everyone. So we will talk about more questions on the Redux, like what are the different middleware choices are there to call the asynchronous calls. So we have two things. You can use a Redux thunk, you can use a Redux saga, or there are another libraries which are providing you the way to call the API's call asynchronously before sending that to the reducer. Okay. So what are the middlewares in the Redux, first of all? So those middlewares are actually something which is placing between your actions to the reducers. You can create a simple logger middleware which is actually logging your state every time. So what is the current state? So you triggered some actions. Now what will be your next state? So you can put that in the console log and you can keep checking the things, what is coming next. So best way to implement all these things, use the Redux dev tool extension with the store. While creating the store, write the code to enable the Redux DevTool extensions where you can keep track of your state based on the actions you are triggering. Why should I use Redux? First of all, don't use Redux directly. There may be a question that when should we use Redux. Don't directly jump to the Redux whenever you have a complex state and when your application component are growing day by day. Then it's better to isolate your state somewhere else. And what is the best choice? We can use the Redux where we can put the state outside in the store of the Redux and can consume from there with the help of applications, with the help of Redux, React Redux library. So state is kept, where the state is kept in the React Redux application. The state is kept inside a store of the Redux. Redux is having the actions, reducers and store. So state is kept inside a store where you can consume that. Okay. What are the three fundamental principles which Redux follows? Redux is following the immutability principle that state are immutable. Every time new state is getting created, it is providing us the single source of truth. Means Redux is providing us the single state object or single state tree which you can consume. Okay, Redux are providing the pure functions. It means the pure functions are pure JavaScript functions where you trigger some actions and you will get the new state object. So reducers are pure JavaScript functions. Okay. What is a map state to the props and map dispatch to the props? These both the methods are the way to access the state from the Redux library or trigger the actions to the Redux. So map dispatch to the props will help us to trigger the actions to the Redux, or map state to the props will help us to capture the state from the Redux library. So both the methods are provided by the React Redux library, and in the connect function we just need to pass them and capture the state and trigger the actions to the Redux. What is Mobex and Flux? You can study both the framework, the Mobex and Flux. I was never interested studying these framework when I know the Redux very well. So these are alternatives of using Redux. If you don't want to use Redux, you can go ahead with the Flux, you can go ahead with the Mobex. Okay, that's it guys. Thanks everyone.